I mean it. I don't want to be on your freaking show. I hate your show.
Just jump.
I'm not gonna jump.
Just jump.
No, I'm not gonna jump.
Please,
really.
Sean Penn.
Jump.
Yeah. I'm not gonna jump.
Your butt.
Can we have our ass?
Yep.
We'd pinch your butt, would you not?
Nope. That would make me angry.
Yeah, but you'd never be able to tell that we didn't pinch your butt and that you just jumped.
Someone got the meds on?
So are you gonna watch on Friday?
Look so. No, I'm not. If you guys put me on, I'm suing.
You're gonna sue?
I'm gonna sue you.
Can you do that?
I think so, because it's on videotape that I said I don't want to be videotaped. No!
I'll never see why.
Like, that's not gonna wind up on the editing room floor.
Live from Beloit, Wisconsin, it's Under the Sheets with Uncle Ted.
Thank you.
Thanks, audience. All right. We're live. Hello. How you doing? We've got an audience today, for once, of three people. And they're laughing. We got a live
time.
Laugh track.
A big time.
Big time. We're going for it now. I don't know what to say. I'm out of here.
We're lying.
Play a rerun. I don't know.
Be a man about it.
So what's up?
We're live.
How you doing?
We're live.
We're live.
I'm a little
and
nervous.
I'd like to say hello to everyone out there in TV land.
The millions.
Who said they were gonna watch us tonight.
Instead of NCAA basketball.
Back. Instead of, yeah, tournament. Dumb tournament. All right, so what have we got on show tonight?
We have...
What's going on?
We have a top five list in my pocket.
Top five. We've got a small news, small town news kind of thing. We've got stuff about spring break, about our trips, all that, right?
Yes, your trip.
We've got my trip. We've got a letter, one letter again.
One letter, we're averaging one letter.
Hey, turn off the half track there, sound. Thanks. I don't know, we've got a bunch of stuff here. We have guests, and possibly, I think, our first female guest. I'm not sure.
It is, ever.
Well, how can you ever tell?
Because I remember. I remembered every show we've ever done.
All right. What do you want to start off with? The small town news?
All right, you read that.
Would like,
story.
Oh, by the way, all through the show, you can call us up on the telephone at 2315?
Yeah, 363.
They figured that out, yeah. 363-2315, I believe.
Area code 608.
And you'll get a little message saying what to do, following the instructions
if
or whatever.
From Rockford.
We're getting a call already.
We're getting calls already.
I can't wait. Matt, are we going to call?
Yes, we do, Ted.
I can't hear you, but that's all right.
Oh.
This is really very exciting. Oh, this is the top five in my pocket.
I'm trying to hear the call here.
Yes, this is Mike Oxong, and I just want to let you know that you can't really hear John. I don't know why. You just can't hear him that well. Right, thank you.
Thanks. Thank you very much. And feel free.
Is that in French?
I don't know. I couldn't hear it.
Possibly German. All right.
Oh, wow.
News.
All right. And that's it. 2315.
People need to know.
Cross up. There's a rumor going around that a man whose lawyer said he had a pistol in his car. Stop calling us, jeez. All right, we're gonna take your call here. Is there another call?
That's a great idea.
So do I. Stop calling for a while.
Bill Donahue.
What's the call? Do you wanna stop? This is a mess.
Just read the news. Just read the news.
All right, well let me hear what this guy's gonna say.
Ted?
Yeah.
How you doing?
Good. Who is this?
This is Harry Balzac. I was just wondering what your favorite type of stone ground wheat cracker is.
Thanks. Hang up.
Thanks for calling.
Get off the air.
Is that toll free?
I hope so. All right. A man whose lawyer said he had a pistol in his car to protect himself from a werewolf will be sentenced in Elkhorn, Wisconsin next month. For carrying a concealed weapon, and that's about it. You know, He says there was a werewolf attacking him. I don't believe him.
You have to check the gun.
Small town news.
You gotta read it all.
Oh, screw it. Alright, stop calling us! Jeez. Alright, and
our operators are pretty busy.
I know. Alright, I'm gonna take this last call. Stop calling for a while. And what is this? Do we have another caller, Matt?
Yeah.
I think Matt is stunned.
Hi, Ted.
Hi.
This is Dave DeGeorge.
Dave! Coach, what's up?
Just wanted you to know I was watching. You look great. Everything seems to be going fine.
Thanks. Hey, and I'm sorry I missed practice.
Yeah, I was wondering about that, quite frankly. 2 o'clock tomorrow.
All right, well, you're on the air, so, you know, that's enough, right?
Hang in there.
All right, Dave.
All right, we'll talk to you tomorrow.
Good.
Wow.
I'm finished. What can I do? All right, that's enough. Stop calling me. All right, top five tonight.
We might have to go overtime.
I know.
We might have to run an hour.
We might have to.
All right.
We have the time.
All right.
Top five.
I have five reasons I have here why we are actually live and not taped. All right.
Shit.
Another call. Should I go or no?
Go. Say right. Top five.
Number five, why we're live. Number five, Quentin's tax on videotape has forced us to abandon the practice of taping the show. We're getting it live. Number four, our editor has become a big pansy. Isn't
it's not
right?
me.
Isn't that right, Ted? Three, we can't do it dead.
Can't do it dead.
Can't do it dead. Number That's two, right. if it's good enough for rock, it's good enough for us.
Definitely.
And the number one reason why we're live, we're just too damn lazy to do it any earlier.
I know. Take the phone off the hook.
Here.
Thank you.
Send this off to the Museum of Broadcasting.
All right. Yeah. Screw it. I can't believe we're doing this.
The cheap prop phone doesn't quite work, does it?
Hello? Hello? I don't know. But, what should
Tell
we do?
Us
we
got some stories.
We got plenty of time to
Uncle
kill.
Uncle Ted?
We got plenty of time to
tell
kill.
Tell us some stories.
You want to tell stories? You want to do what?
I want to hear stories.
You want to hear stories?
I have no stories to tell.
Well, tell me a little bit about your vacation to set me up.
I just went home.
You went home.
And dreamed of spring.
I think there's play going on in the next room. We got a live TV show here.
Live
TV.
It's
gone. And, you know, you didn't do anything you said. Go to any bars or anything?
A couple.
Yeah? And what happened? Tell us about your country bar story.
I went to a country bar.
Uh-huh.
And watched people dance, and then got into a fight and got thrown out. All right, maybe not quite like that.
I don't believe that. I've never heard that.
More or less, that's what happened. So,
really?
Yeah.
So I. All right. All right. Well,
I swear.
You know, on the way home from my trip, John, I decided to write out, you know, my memories of what my trip would be like.
On a bag.
On this bag. And actually, I bought you something in this bag, but I can't present it to you yet. I think you already saw it, but
I was looking through your stuff.
Because it's for someone too.
All right.
All right.
I'm surprised.
Well, first of all, I went with our director, Matt, who doesn't know how to, you know, use the sound machine.
Well, he's young. He'll learn.
He'll learn. He has plenty of time. And then we have, you know, two foreign guys, one from Finland. And
Finland.
One from Hong Kong.
Should I point these out?
So, no, it's all right. It's towards you.
Finland
but,
and
you know,
Hong Kong.
So they're not very good with their English. Neither am I must say, but...
That's true.
You know. So anyway, we go down to Louisiana for vacation. It takes 15 hours to get down
the
there.
The home of the blues.
Home of the blues. St. Louis blues. What? Sure. All right. That's Missouri, I think. Anyway, it takes 15 hours to get down there.
Right. 15 hours to get back?
No.
No.
But I'll tell that later.
Sorry.
Anyway, that was a pretty good trip down there. And we left at 12 midnight for some reason. I don't know.
To avoid the police.
Exactly.
All right.
But avoid the speeding tickets.
Avoid the speeding tickets.
And when we get down there, we're staying with basically the Chinese guy's uncle.
The Chinese man's uncle.
And he has this wife who doesn't speak a word of English. Right.
Uh-huh.
So we come home, we're in his house, and we have another phone call. And anyway, we're in his house, prying around. Let me answer this first. Hello? Is anybody there? All right, we're stalling here.
Janitor.
Can you stall for time? I don't know. All right, that's a decline. Get lost. All right, so we get in this house, right?
In the house.
And this Chinese woman comes in, and she's yelling at us in Chinese.
Wow.
So we're going, and we don't, you know what the heck to do.
You were scared.
We were scared. So,
you were scared.
You know, we tried to run.
Run? You tried to run?
Even the Chinese guy didn't know who this woman was. So, I'm sick of that phone, man.
So she was burglarizing. She was
She thought
up.
We were burglars or something.
And she had a gun?
Yeah, and I tried to explain things to her, but she only spoke Chinese. So, what was I to do? And it was very strange. That's all I had to say. But,
So you're nearly beaten up by a Chinese woman.
Exactly.
Wow.
And then, you know, we get down there. We go out our first night to this bar. Someone on the phone?
No.
No? All right, and we go to this bar, and I have this little short friend who's about, you know, 5'2" or something.
What's his name?
Anthony.
Anthony, your friend.
Aunt Anthony.
Aunt Anthony.
Right.
Wow.
And so he's hitting on every chick in this bar, and then we're sitting around, you know, with two foreigners just like this, kind of playing pool and stuff. Right. So that wasn't too exciting. But, you know, the next day, Matt and I had an exciting time.
Oh,
we went
yes.
to Clybert's Alligator Farm.
Clybert's
I forgot
alligator
to bring
farm.
The pictures.
All right, no pictures.
Alligator and turtle farm. Wow. And these huge 18-foot alligators.
18 feet.
I was really impressed. It's.
Were you scared
I've
then,
seen
too?
18 feet somewhere before. Can't place it, though.
Wow.
Then I got stuffed at a restaurant, blah, blah, blah. We had a lot of excitement down there. We watched 5 movies in one day once.
Wow, that might be a record. Call Guinness.
What topped the charts? What movie topped the charts, Matt? Do you remember that?
Shakes.
Whitney Houston's Body.
You said Shakes.
That would be Shakes the Clown.
Yes. I've heard many of stories about
that
Shakes.
Too exciting. You know, and I think I'm going to roll my life after him or something.
Brady's in that?
Yeah, Mrs. Brady.
Mrs. Brady?
She gets laid or something.
By Shakes?
I can't say it.
Can you say
that?
I don't know.
Uh-oh. Oh,
now they're calling up. Jeez.
Yeah,
all right, so, you know, we played about 20 million hours of pool down there because there was nothing really to do.
20 million hours?
Just about. And went to New Orleans.
That's a record for sure.
Went to New Orleans. We're right on Bourbon Street, the famous Party Street. We had a lot of fun.
Good.
Our audience knows it.
They recognize
it. And I wish people would stop calling on the phone because I'm going to break their necks. And, you know, we went to, I can't say that one.
You went to where?
I can't, that has to do with another show.
Oh, another show. Oh, another episode.
Yeah. All right, so then there was the big storm when we were coming home, right?
The storm of the century.
Storm of the century, and the baseball team got caught in that, softball team, everyone. Right? So we're coming home, and it so happens I started out driving. It was pouring rain, you know.
Wow.
I got through just fine because I'm an excellent driver, right? And the other guys are sweeping and everything. So, anyway, that wasn't the bad part of it. Then we had the Chinese guy driving. He's never driven in snow before, right?
Sure.
And that was pretty bad.
They don't have snow
in
China.
We'd be you know, slipping all over.
Wow.
Right?
You could have been killed.
This was in Missouri, by the way.
Missouri.
And then,
the show me state.
Then, yeah. And then we had this guy from Finland who doesn't know how to drive in snow.
Figure that
That's
one.
That's very odd.
Figure that one.
I don't know. And then we have Matt, our director, from Milwaukee.
He can drive in snow.
I'll just say, Matt, you know, you're pretty good. Driver, you were a pretty good driver, but you know, there was this one ice bridge we came up with, and Matt starts sliding, right? So he figures, put on the brakes, right? So he slams on the brakes, we're going left and right, you know, I don't know, I'm panicking, I'm pulling hair out of the Chinese guy and stuff. So,
are you crying?
Yeah, I said, lay off the brakes, Matt, and we were saved, thanks to me. All right, now the worst
you're a
part.
Hero, Ted.
The worst part coming home. I was the only real guy who knew how to drive in the snow, since I'm just a stud I am.
And you're also very modest.
Thanks. And so.
Did you have chains on the tires?
No, we had nothing on the tires.
Wow.
And so we're driving home, right, through Missouri. Lots of snow.
Lots of snow.
And what should happen but the gas tank meter was off. It was broken.
Oh, no.
So we run out of gas.
Ted?
And you know, there's three...
Hey, Ted.
Three of my... Yeah.
I'd just like to remind you that lying is against FCC rules.
Lying is against FCC rules.
Lying is against FCC
rules. But Ted, I can sympathize.
Whatever.
All right, and there's three big fears that come to mind when I'm driving, John. Do you know three?
Grizzly bears?
I guess not. One is getting into an accident.
Accident?
Number two is being stopped by a cop.
Cops?
Because I hate
and grizzly bears.
Yeah. And the third one is...
Grizzly bears.
And the third one is running out of gas.
Running out of gas.
In a car full of foreigners.
And being eaten by grizzly bears.
No, running out of gas in a car full of foreigners is pretty bad. Because, you know, these guys are just... Oh, I don't know. I can't explain it. I barely made it out.
They're all foreign.
Speed it up. All right. Screw you. We have an hour, man.
This is a boring story, Ted.
I know. And anyway, so we run out of gas. These guys stop for us. Once I get in the car, they're like, oh, man. We were afraid you were black.
Me?
No. These guys said that I was afraid I was black. So was I in fear for my life that they might have killed me just because I said African-American or something like that.
Wow.
Being the conscious guy I am. And,
would have been scarier with
you. You know, it was pretty bad. And the foreigners just got on my back. So why don't we,
they got on your back?
Take a letter now. We have a special guest. Hi. You want to sit down?
You're on TV. Is your name Josh?
Yeah.
Yeah. This is Josh.
Hey, Josh.
Say hi to Beloit, Wisconsin.
You're on live TV.
Hi, Josh.
Wow.
We're getting so many.
There's a story here for school.
All right. Now, let's go to a letter, huh? All right, we're going to a letter because it's getting very boring. It's 8:48 already, jeez. Dear Ted and John, I really like your music compilations.
Thank you.
Would you please play another? And yes, we will. And that was Phil McCracken again. He keeps writing us.
He loves our show.
I don't know. So yes, we will. In fact, we made this... less than a year ago when this group became famous. Why don't we play it? You got that queued up, Matt? All right, here it is.
Yes, he does. Yeah,
All right.
Wow.
We couldn't show the rest of that performance.
One of the studio lights came crashing down, and there was a small fire, and for the next 20 minutes, Ted ran around yelling, "I'm flaming, I'm flaming." So.
Yeah, but everyone knew that.
We would like to express apology to everyone who we took recordings of and weren't in the video.
Yeah.
We're sorry, but there's a dumb guy who's just...
Bad light.
Exactly.
Wisconsin light.
So, what else is on your mind? Nothing, all right.
I think we came up with some new technology.
We did?
Over the past week.
We have another phone call.
We do.
New
technology, some camera work. Some experimental camera work
that
maybe we could show.
So, someone, all right, hello? Hello?
Denise?
I can't hear him.
This is Denise. And I was just like,
Sorry not.
Watching your show, it was great. That was a great video there.
Wow, thanks.
Thanks.
Hey, okay.
You too.
Bye.
Wow. That was sweet.
I feel like checking out the doggy cam, don't you?
Yeah, we worked on this.
I wonder what what's going on in doggy world right now.
Engineering.
What's on the doggy cam?
Spent.
Let's see, what's on the doggy cam?
We're working on it.
Get away. Get away. Get away. Get out of here. What? Mangy mutt. Stop this. Get out of here.
I hope no one was hurt.
I hope our equipment wasn't hurt.
Yeah.
I don't know.
That was nice. I think maybe we can get that fixed so we could have that up and operational 24 hours a day.
I really don't give it a, you know. All right, so I think it's time for our guest. I mean, we've delayed long enough.
You've delayed
we've
long
been,
enough.
I know, we've been on a long time. That was just a bad story.
I couldn't have said that better myself.
All right, so why don't we bring on our first female guest?
Good
morning!
Good morning!
I like the green one.
Tape for this?
Whoa. Ow.
We have a tape expressing our feelings. What's going on?
Look at all these
all
balloons.
Right. Well, forget the tape. Thanks a lot for ruining it.
Balloons. Free balloons for everyone
Free
who's
balloons.
Here.
You want a balloon, Josh?
Yeah.
Go for it.
You can have them all.
Yeah, take them all.
Except for the orange ones.
So, ladies.
Yeah.
How are you?
Good.
Good, Ted.
Glad to be here.
Your names, please. Who are you?
Hi, I'm Denise Bracco.
I'm Sandra Keller. All
right.
Wow.
And, all right, so we got Beth and Denise here. And both wearing orange, very nice. John, do you have something for them?
I think we all have something for them.
I don't know.
Just reach down under the desk.
What do we got under here?
You should have worn orange.
I didn't.
Whoa! You need this. Just for our first female guest.
I'll just take this one.
We got a cake for you too. There. Have it. It's
open
done.
The cake.
It's over. You can open it. We'll eat after.
That
can we
have open that up.
Ice cream.
Sure. Anything for our first female guest.
It's only $3.99 though.
Hey.
You put.
It's $3.99 before we added the special.
Oh, there's a lady with my flower.
Oh,
huh? All right, good. Hey, put the, there we go. Our new
careful.
Mantle.
Careful.
There, look at that.
Nice. All right, so, Both of you played on the volleyball team. And
oh, great season.
Great season.
Great.
Good.
As long as it's fun, that's all that counts.
I can give a personal documentary from the bench.
Wow, you sound a little bitter.
Yeah. It's getting a little hot in here.
It's not whether you win or lose, it's how you play the game.
It's how you watch the game.
Wow. All right, and Denise is also on the softball team.
Yeah.
Right, and you have any other teams, Beth?
Nope.
All right.
She's on my team.
In Amaro's, we beat Denise's team.
Yeah, you sure.
Yeah.
And Denise's team beat Ted's team the night before.
Well, did you notice we brought the special lips couch for you?
It's nice. I don't know. Can we take this back to our room?
Well, we were kind of hoping John would sit in between us, but
yeah, no.
All right. Well. We prepared a few questions for you. You ask these. Jeez.
I'll ask them.
Here, would you hand these to my friend?
We looked these up in the World Book, so we'd like to thank the people at World Book. Since you are representing your gender, your entire gender, we have some questions. So, number one, when were women granted the right to vote?
I hope Professor Hodge answers. Because he did
way back when.
Okay, 1920.
Yes.
Wow.
All right. Next question. What amendment to the Constitution allowed for this?
Wait,
19.
Wow.
We got a real
history. All right. Now we'll shift gears to volleyball.
Oh, here we go.
In what country was volleyball invented?
America,
that's right.
Wow, 3 for 3.
We are good.
Maybe your smartest guess ever. Even right. Over Pat Pauly.
Are we your only guess?
Tonight.
For women's competition, how high is the volleyball net?
About
yay high. Like if you yay stand high. Up here, it's
comes
like this
fingertips.
Far. Yep.
Sure. All right, close.
It's really a little give and take
close,
there.
Close enough to count.
Yeah, that's right there.
That's it. 7 feet,
2.2 meters,
a quarter inches. Yeah. Oh wow, she converted.
Wow.
All right. How long is a volleyball court?
Oh, it's about 60 feet, 18 meters.
Wow.
Is that right?
Are you a math major?
I am not.
Oh, wow.
History.
I don't like
that's
this.
Why I got
all right.
This.
Let's get on to the real questions, shall we?
These real questions.
These are
those
the real
are not
questions.
The real questions.
All right. How wide? That's how wide is the volleyball court?
30 feet.
30 feet.
9
wow.
meters.
Wow. Amazing. Wow. All right.
That's what you were talking.
This is a tough one. True or false? Volleyball games provide spirited fun and exercise for young people and adults.
False.
False.
I think that's a true type of a question to ask.
It's
all depends.
It's a trick question.
Trick question. Never mind.
All right. Well, according to World Book,
it's true.
Yeah.
That's
the
right.
fun's taken out of the game.
So. There you go. You guys did very well.
Very well.
Especially you're proud of the metric conversion.
Do we get a prize?
You get a bunny rabbit.
You get a big kiss from them.
Oh,
that's
man.
A losing prize. You've never heard of one.
No doubt.
Oh, phone call!
More people wanting kisses.
Wow.
From Ted.
Yeah, thanks. But, all right. We have some more real questions, don't we?
Ted?
We got one.
All right. Do we have a phone call? Is that affirmative?
I think that was an
eye. Hey,
Pepe, won't it? Pepe, yeah, Pepe. Hey, Pepe.
Pepe,
are you here?
Yes. Yeah, we'd like to hear some men on the show.
Nah.
I think we get the women off the show and get some real men.
Maybe even start now.
All right, hang up. Pepe doesn't want to talk right now. Get lost. All right, so volleyball didn't go so hot. And,
I'm saying that.
You're listening.
Wow, Ted's passing judgment.
We have a fan over here.
But do you have any more questions, Sean?
Oh, that's fine.
Sean,
I have no questions.
Yeah?
No. I want some rabbit cake.
Really? How did both of your vacations go? You're not getting rabbit cake.
Good.
All right.
Good.
I want some rabbit cake.
Do you have any funny stories for us about? Talk about on the spot.
Not on the top of my head there,
No.
That's some people great. Had to stay here, didn't they?
I heard about the fight John got in at the Country Western bar.
Yeah.
And that got kicked too. Out.
That made it across AP, I think.
You really can't follow a story like that.
It was picked up by the wire services and spread across the world.
All right. It's getting pretty...
We want some cake.
So, you guys want some cake?
You want some cake?
Yeah, we do.
The stuff's over there.
Oh, we have one more thing.
Another present?
Oh, yes. Well, can I open it?
We have a present for, answering all those questions.
You want some cake?
Yep.
All right, we'll give you some cake.
For answering all the questions, we have for you some smoked sausage made with pork, chicken, and beef, soy protein concentrate added.
How'd you know?
Packed in meat stock.
No.
And John will read the ingredients here.
Put it back.
Pass it over.
Yeah, I'm going to open it up.
How'd they get this picture of you on here?
Oh, this is me.
Read the ingredients.
Okay, this is the butt. Here.
Look at you.
Here's a fork.
You can go sit on the chair.
I think we've turned into a restaurant here.
All right, I'm opening this up.
I don't know what's going on.
What if we didn't want it open?
This is why. Ooh,
this might be bad.
And under the sheets. Here, read the ingredients, will you?
I'm scared, Ted. Ted, I'm passing this back to you.
You're opening it? Well, I don't want to smell this. All right, it's made with chicken, pork stomachs, water, pork skins, pork spleens, pork tongue trimmings, beef tripe, pork, beef, soy protein concentrate. Oh, I can't pronounce the rest.
Ted,
16
Ted.
Oh, careful.
Ted, get that.
Oh, come on, man. It's all fun and games. All
right, so you guys want to go? Take off, or do you want to keep going?
Eat the head.
Are you kicking us off?
Yes, interesting.
Do you want to see anything else?
Eat the head, Ted. Do your Ozzy Osbourne impression. Bite the head off the rabbit.
That's cute.
One of my friends had those last night, matter of fact. No lie.
Really? Stop.
Flirt.
Here, you guys.
I'm
you guys
having these on my cake.
Flirt has them.
Oh my god.
We need to use like a diamond.
Can we get a shot of Ted's? Get a nice close shot of Ted's plate. Oh, well, don't spill it.
And
I'll give you $1 if you eat one.
Jesus. I'll give you down to this.
I'll give you $2 if you smoke one.
Oh man.
Yeah, we
big off, huh?
How's the cake, Josh? Good.
All right, and that's about it for the show, right? Is that what you come out to say? Thanks for watching live under the sheets.
Come on, have some
cake. And we'll be on next
Join
week
us.
With maybe
it's
a regular episode. Come on, Andy. He helped a lot. He helped
come
out
have some
the show.
Cake.
Come on, Drew.
Oh, so did Matt.
We like to thank.
Right. Everyone's welcome.
We like to
roll
thank Richard.
The credits. We're out of here.
I see Matt.
See ya. Where the credits? There you go.
Oh my God.
Cake.
I made you do that. I wanted to save it. That's the number of my time.
What, the cake?
The head.
No, I didn't cut the flowers are still.
I ripped the head.
They really. That's not the good ones.
Wow, soft and moist.
It's good. It is. It's really good. I know. I didn't do it.